Hurricane Helene.
Good luck, everybody.
This morning, a monster storm unleashing its fury overnight on Florida's Gulf Coast. Hurricane Helene, a catastrophic Category 4, showing no mercy, destroying property, flooding hotel lobbies, businesses, and homes, and submerging...
What do you think the over-under on the damage from this one is going to be? Because I think we're looking in, like, tens of billions. I mean, we're talking about, like, mass flooding in so much of... Yeah.
...vehicles in oceans of water.
This is terrible.
Helene not only bringing hurricane force winds to the region, but also a historic storm surge. And tonight, on top of all this, the threat of tornadoes.
Violent winds up to 100 miles per hour
clip.
Slamming into Florida.
People driving
flood
on
water
through it.
Sending waves over this highway in Tampa. And treacherous driving conditions with trees blocking roads and this boat completely shored up. Unsurvivable storm surge transforming neighborhoods with chest-high water.
Hurricane Ian did $115 billion. $115 billion? That much? Maybe I'm way off in my estimation. $113 billion from Hurricane Ian. And this is worse than Hurricane Ian. Hurricane Ian was the costliest hurricane in Florida history, third costliest tropical cyclone on record. And this one's worse than that, so...
Water in some areas and homes completely flooded inside.
Hello. Hello,
leaving
Florida,
this
man
to take refuge in a kayak, and torrents of water slamming into bridges as well, turning roads into rivers. All of it inundating towns right in the center of Florida's Gulf coastline.
I've worked here in this organization for 21 years. These are the highest surge numbers I've ever seen.
And this moment lighting up the night sky, showing what appears to be a possible transformer exploding in St. Petersburg.
Cool.
The storm leaving more than a million customers without power across the region. Tampa General putting up an aqua fence in place to keep the water at bay, and it held up.
In this backpack, I have...
Some on Florida State's campus in Tallahassee forced to shelter in place.
We're going to be away through the night watching this through the window.
The overnight landfall of Helene challenging for rescue teams forced to save lives in the dark. As many as 40 people pulled from the rising water in Pasco County. And facing dangerous conditions with one crew in Pinellas County encountering homes engulfed in flames.
How?
Anybody in your house?
In Clearwater, the elderly helped to safety, being carried out by first responders.
Once the winds start getting up to a certain point, we even have to hunker down.
And extraordinary rescues captured on camera, like the Coast Guard saving this man and his dog after his sailboat capsized off Sanibel Island.
Okay, literally, what the fuck are you doing on a sailboat out there? I feel like they should have left you out there. This is me being a little bit mean, and I feel bad for the dog, but holy shit, are you kidding me? Get the dog. Yeah, get the dog. Like, go out there, get the dog, and then you can leave the guy, I guess. Are you fucking kidding me?
And we're back out now live with the damage here in Perry, Florida. Emergency.
They might have been unlucky and couldn't get to harbor in time. We knew about the hurricane days in advance. I'm not, nah. Dude, the National Guard, or the Coast Guard, man, they got stuff they need to be doing. They're out here saving your dumbass. You've got the SOS out because you were junking it. Like 12 miles off the coast?
Emergency management officials up and down the coast are pleading with Floridians this morning to please stay inside of their homes if there was damage in their city or towns, because when you see images like this, it is just still too dangerous. And in some cases, Hoda, rescues are still happening. Back
all
to you.
Right, Tommy Amos Forest.
Yeah, it's pretty bad. Here's some drone footage with, you know, penis music playing. This happens with every hurricane, I swear. No one thinks it's going to be them. Apparently, Lake Lure Dam in North Carolina is about to fail. Or no, wait, it would have failed already. This tweet is from a few hours ago. National Weather Service, GSP, flash flood emergency for Lake Lure Dam, dam failure imminent. That's a spooky-ass tweet. Psych, you are spamming, though, and I already directly acknowledged you. Shh. Jet at it again. What the hell even happened here? Okay. We didn't need the music. Never mind. This is just showing, like, the rural areas. You know, Steinhatchee, Florida. I don't know where the f*** that is. Fort Myers, Florida is underwater. Sheesh. Weather reporter interrupts live report to save woman. I would also go to any lengths to save women. That's just the kind of guy I am.
All right, now let's check in with Fox weather reporter Bob Van Dillen, who went in that water, saved that lady from her submerged car in Atlanta. Bob, you are a hero. You were live on the air. We could hear her screaming, and you said, guys, I can't continue this live shot. I've got to go into the water. And
controversial position we're going to front it. Is he a hero? Because I think a hero is somebody who does something selflessly. And this wasn't selfless at all, because now he gets to feel like pogged up forever. I would say, if anything, he came out the better of the two, like between him and her. Like, she gets her life, and that's important, don't get me wrong. But now he gets to, like, forever be... He's going to have this playing on loop on the living room TV, you know? I don't know. Why were they filming a dying person? Well, he was giving a weather report, and then presumably behind him, the lady was stuck in the car, so he ran off to save her. Yeah, I would say he's actually like Hitler, for all the pussy he's going to get from this, you know? What a selfish asshole, saving her life.
And get this lady and rescue her. What did she say to you?
She was.
I'm kidding. I know you autistic motherfuckers are gonna. I'm kidding. It's a really cool thing to do.
She was panicking. She really wasn't making too much sense, and she was still strapped into her car seat. She was still had the seat buckle on.
Obviously, I hate that.
And she had her window about this much down, and she's trying to talk to me through that. So I'm trying to open up the door, Ansley, and the water pressure wasn't allowing me to do it. So I said, roll your window down. So she rolls it down, and that allowed the more water to get in. But yeah, and it allowed me to open the door. Yeah,
at what point is autism just an excuse for being unaware? That's a good point. At what point is it a skill issue? You know what I mean? Maybe you're just not being respectful enough to listen to what I'm saying.
You'll see the windshield wipers are slapping time right there, right? So the battery's still alive and kicking in that car. In fact, I think the engine is still on. But yeah, it's amazing. The water itself is relatively warm. The water temperature is about 80 degrees.
Right.
It's up to my chest, and there's a little bit of a current, but she was a short...
This is in Atlanta too. This isn't in Tallahassee. This is all the way in Georgia. Like, it's this bad that far in. I mean, I know Atlanta isn't crazy far in from the coast, but you know, it's not on the coast.
Short lady too, so she was probably about 5 feet. There's no way she was going to be able to touch. I just put her on my back and brought her up. But you can see how high that water is, you guys. I mean, that's a street sign right here. It goes down pretty quickly. I didn't realize how deep it was. Yeah. I mean, you kind of tiptoe in there, and I've got my boots. But wow.
Well, Bob, you know.
God damn. Sadly, that weather guy died later that night, drowning in pussy. True. That's so true.
We begin with the breaking news, Helene. That's video of crews racing to rescue people trapped inside burning homes in that part of Florida. The storm went from a Category 1 to a Category 4 hurricane and then back to a tropical depression today, cool. All within the span of 24 hours. Right now, multiple states are facing once-in-a-lifetime flooding. Just look at those images.
I don't think it's going to be once-in-a-lifetime. I'm really sad. We're going to have to retire that term pretty soon, you know? I don't think it's...
More than 3 million people without power. According to our NBC affiliate, WCYB in northeastern Tennessee, more than 50...
Is higher or lower categories more... Higher category means higher wind speed. The big problem with this one, though, wasn't necessarily the wind speed. It was how large it was, because that drew up more water and increased the storm surge and the amount of water being thrown around. Like, wind is dangerous, but the main threat is usually, like, how much flooding there's going to be, either from the sea being pulled up, or from the flash flooding from the storm.
50 patients and staff members were trapped on the roof of a hospital earlier today because of rising floodwaters there. Our NBC News crews have this storm completely covered. We've got Kathy Park in Florida for us. We've got Priscilla Thompson in Georgia, meteorologist Bill Cairns tracking where Helene is headed next. Kathy, I want to start with you. I mean, we can see the destruction behind you. I know you're on the Gulf Coast, kind of near where Helene made land.
Are most deaths caused by the wind knocking over trees and stuff? It depends on the severity. For smaller storms, it's usually you get a couple people dying from, like, the wind maybe, or like a bit of a flood. But once the flooding gets bad enough, you get real death tolls. It's easier to see examples of this in other countries that don't have the same emergency preparedness systems. Like, you can take a look at the Philippines or whatever. You know, there are some historical storms there that have killed tens of thousands of people. And the flooding does the real nasty work in the long run. Basically shuts everything down. I mean, you can look at Katrina as well. you know? Though the main issue with Katrina wasn't just the storm. It was the fact that they didn't give a shit about, like, helping black people after it, because New Orleans is, like, 99% black people. So they just kind of left the city to rot.
And fall overnight. What are you seeing? What are you hearing about what happened overnight and then today, the recovery?
Kate, good afternoon. So the damage is widespread here in Steinhatchee, and it's really just devastating to see all of this up close. The storm surge here in this area reached roughly 15 feet, and it looks like the storm swallowed a portion of this community. We're standing in what used to be a longtime restaurant, Roy's, and you can see
the
toppled cinder blocks, the kitchen appliances scattered everywhere. There are utensils on the ground as well. We're going to swing our camera over to the right here, and this is the river.
Straight up and like deleted the building, it looks like.
When the storm surge came in, all of this water pushed over. You can see that.
I'm glad I left, but I'm glad I still have a house left. So I got something to work on. So.
And you got a chance to go up there. What did you see inside?
Well, it's got mud and all that, and everything's been floated around.
And Kate, something else to point out, a lot of these
actual GTA 6 character, POV, you're a live stream chatter who's familiar with all of the, you know, all the terminology employed by like Generation Alpha, but you have never actually seen a Floridian before, and everything that you know and experience is framed through like how much Rockstar prepped you for it. Me on Google Street View showing you guys Rodeo Drive, and every single human in chat is like, I've been here in GTA 5.
Roads in this area completely impassable. You'll notice debris scattered on the roadways, trees toppled over. That's another restaurant over there to my left. We were told that it actually just got rebuilt from Hurricane Idalia from last year. So this is just adding insult to injury.
And none of these guys are getting a payout either. Insurance companies don't, like, what insurance company would provide storm protection in Florida? Are you insane? Do you want to go bankrupt? Are you kidding me? The state provides some, but even then, like, past a point, it becomes unsustainable. It's like an economic black hole. It'd be like building a restaurant in an active volcano. Hey, the wooden supports caught fire again. Insurance company, waiter, can I get money to rebuild my restaurant over the caldera of the volcano, please? No.
And Kate, we should also point out that there were mandatory evacuations here in Taylor County. It appears a lot of people heeded those warnings, but some people did hunker down and ride out the storm in this location. As of now, we haven't heard of any deaths.
At the very least, like, if you're going to build in Florida, you have to build storm-ready buildings. And Americans hate the idea of living in a way that takes into account, like, the needs of nature. You know, I don't want to do the whole noble savage thing or whatever, but we might unironically want to take some lessons here from indigenous communities in terms of, like, maybe it makes sense that we shouldn't be building the same houses in Florida, Phoenix, the Bronx, and Seattle. Like, maybe it would make sense if we didn't build the same type of house in everywhere, you know? You can't build storm surge proof buildings. No, but you can build much more resistant ones. And also, you can build ones that are less expensive. I mean, past a point, you just have to invest less, right? Florida buildings are not the same at all, Vosh. You're just wrong here. I don't literally think they're all the same. I do think, and I'm not arguing about this with you because I'm right and God tells me that I'm right when he speaks to me before I go to sleep every night. I know for a fact that the construction practices that we employ all around the United States do not take into account like the specific weather and climate occurrences in that area, because we have standardized building practices and construction companies want to operate in ways that allow them to make the most amount of money possible. And it's not like they're on the hook for insurance. So, you know, they build with the materials and the processes that they're familiar with, which means they can bang these constructions out relatively quickly, but it doesn't always mean that they're building them in ways that are like intelligently acclimated to the environment.
It's here in Steinhatchee, but obviously the day is still young. Folks are out here assessing the damage right now, but one official did tell NBC News that he wishes that he urged people to evacuate sooner.
God is telling me this.
We talked to a sheriff nearby earlier last hour, Kathy, and he was saying, you know, this is a cautionary tale. Don't ride out these storms. Kathy, thank you.
Thanks for watching.
I mean, shut up. We have to think about this like kind of systemically, right? Because otherwise, what do? Just spend $1 trillion every year on this? You know, like what do we do then? A lot of the damage isn't even visible because once the water gets into the foundations of the home, it erodes. Like the cost of replacing eroded foundation wood and you know, just wood in general, I guess, all over the bit. Like the damage that's done, a lot of it's not visible. Like just because you see a house standing doesn't mean that it's fine. Kind of concrete too, yeah. At least 50 patients and staff are trapped on the roof of the Unicoi County Hospital in Tennessee. Base, Dusty Poncho. Florida did a pretty significant overhaul of their building codes in 2002 after Hurricane Andrew. I'm not familiar with the specifics. When God talks to me, he's not usually that specific. I'd have to look at it. I'm sure they can do more. It's Florida. Sheesh! Well, it's pretty. Advice to people who live in flood-prone areas, keep an axe in your attic. Yeah, so you can chop up the attic to get out onto the roof when you need to. I would just punch through the roof, you know, me personally, but I can understand for maybe, like, some of you guys and girls, you might need, like, a fire axe up there. God damn. Look at this. The dam failure. Very dangerous situation in Newport, Tennessee due to a catastrophic dam. The Waterville Dam. Look at the water level here. And then this is where the dam failed. Zoom. That seems bad. Yeah. Waterville Dam. Can I get like a picture of it? I want a visual reference for how large it is. Because I don't know. Dam failures kill a lot of people. Okay, this doesn't show me what it looks like. Waterville Dam. This is the dam? Oh, it's like a real dam. I know that dams vary a lot in size. Obviously, they're all real dams. I'm not dam shaming or anything, but it's like actually properly a real dam. Huh. Yeah, that could totally kill a lot of people if it goes. Which it did go. It went. It has gone. Past tense. Is there any official death toll? The last time I saw a death toll, it was something in the ballpark of 50, but that's probably an understatement. A lot of people get lost in the storm, you know? It's probably going to end up being some, like, probably like 150 people. Maybe that's an understatement. I'm not sure. I'm kind of just guessing, really. Yeah, why would you call a dam Waterville? You're invoking the name of your enemy. Don't do that.